Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. In today's tutorial, I'll show you how to make a pom-pom using the Clover pom-pom maker. For today's tutorial, you'll need your pom-pom maker, and you'll need a pair of scissors, and of course, you'll need your yarn. I'm going to use some 100% acrylic yarn today. It's a worsted weight, Aran weight, also called 12 ply. Before you begin wrapping your yarn around the pom-pom maker, you're going to cut a piece of yarn around about 15 inches long. To get started, grab your pom-pom maker and you're going to open one end. So you've got one end here and then you've got another end on the opposite side, and they're both exactly the same. So open one end like so and make sure that the two legs here are aligned together. And then once they're aligned, grab your yarn. And I'm going to start at this outer edge here. And I'm going to place my yarn around the end like this. And then I'm going to begin wrapping my yarn around. And I'm just going to do it in a single layer. And you can push the yarn up to make it nice and tight. And I'm just going to continue wrapping my yarn around in a single layer until I get to the other side. I've reached the other side, and you want to make sure that your yarn reaches the edge on each side here. And now I'm going to start wrapping my yarn all the way up until I get to this edge. And again, I'll be doing this in a single layer. As you can see, I've reached the other edge, and now I'm going to start wrapping the yarn around in the other direction. So I've reached the other side, and I'm just going to go back in the opposite direction now. And I'll be working in this manner, going up one direction and then going in the opposite direction, until this part here is completely full with yarn. I've just finished wrapping my yarn around this end of the pom-pom maker, and you can see that the dip in the middle is now completely full of yarn, so it's now completely flat. And it's really important that you fill this up nice and full, and this is what will give the pom-pom its nice round fluffy shape. And then I'm just going to grab my scissors and snip the end off and then I'm just going to push this end in like so. And then I'm going to open the other end. And I'm going to repeat the same process on this end. So make sure that the two legs are both aligned. And then just grab your yarn, place it around the end, and then you'll start wrapping your yarn backwards and forwards until this part here is completely full of yarn and it's nice and level. As you can see, I've just finished filling the other end up and I'm just going to close it over, push it in, and then I'll just snip this end off. And then what you're going to do is grab your scissors and at one end, any end, it doesn't matter, you're going to begin cutting your yarn down the middle. So I'm just going to put my scissors in here and I'm going to begin cutting. So I've just cut one end and I'll do the same on the other side. So I've just finished cutting the other side and then grab the piece of yarn that you cut earlier on and you're going to put it through the middle here. Bring it round to the other side. So I put it in through here and then wrapped it around. And I'm going to tie a knot. And pull it nice and tight. And then I'll make another knot. Again, pull it nice and tight. And then I'm going to wrap it around in the other direction. And I'm going to make another couple of knots. And then I'm going to open up one end. And then open up the other end. And then I'm going to grab this part here on one side and it's the same on the other side. So I'm just using my forefinger and my thumb. Grab hold of each end and then just pull it. And then this is when you're going to tidy up your pom-pom. So grab your scissors and start cutting the straggly bits off. And I'm going to give mine a good trim to cut the straggly bits off and give it a nice uniform round shape. And here's my pom-pom all finished. I just sat down for a few minutes and gave it a good trim to coax it into a nice round and uniform shape. I really hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and found it helpful. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell icon so you don't miss out on any future videos that I upload. Thanks for watching.